Once upon a time, in long ago days of yonder yo, there was a queen. Not of the fairy tale variety, for she was as real as she was regal, royal, powerful, and in time she became great. At her command was the most powerful navy on the seven seas and oceans. They explored and exploited her vast domain, and as a result, many products and riches flowed into her kingdom. She formed a commonwealth of nations that she mentored that was so vast, it was said the sun never set upon her distant shores. So it was that she summoned leaders from far-flung regions to visit and consult with her on trade and commerce, as well as defense of their newfound nationhood. On this day, December 12, 1894, there was a leader from a distant land called, interestingly enough, Canada. The Queen and her court received him and others with great pomp and fanfare. They all gathered in her castle named Windsor, and in a grandiose ceremony they were inducted into her Privy Council Hall of Fame. As might be expected, when the business was concluded, the Queen led them into the grand dining room that was set for lunch, but food was not served immediately as the ladies flocked to the loo to powder their noses and touch up their lipstick. The Queen was entertaining some of her guests with her witty conversation when there was a dreadful gasp, followed by a high-pitched shriek. All eyes turned to the distressed damsel, who was standing next to a gentleman who appeared to have fallen asleep on the Queen's fine china. The Queen quickly summoned her personal physician, while others rushed to his aid. None too soon, the doc comes rushing into the room and finds the guests have revived him with some brandy and water. He takes the seat next to the gentleman, noting he looks ghastly and is as white as a sheet. He says, "Sir John, just a little subnote here. Sir John is the Canadian Prime Minister I alluded to earlier. I thought this would be a very interesting place to him into the unfolding story. I think it gives the yarn quite an interesting Canadian twang. I'm so glad that you agree. Now, where was I? Oh yeah. Sir John," says the doc, "how are you feeling?" Sir John clenches his fist to his bosom and wheezes, "My death!" Whereupon he keels over into the astonished doctor's arms. Many, including the Queen, gasped and a murmur went throughout the hall. The doctor gently guides him to the floor, but he hits it with quite a kerthunk. He checks his pulse and vital signs without delay before standing up and announcing, "Ladies and gentlemen, I am sorry to say, Sir John is dead." There were shrieks and cries, and some ladies fainted. Many tears were shed that day, none more than the Queen, for she had knighted him many years earlier for services he had rendered unto her kingdom. He put a real damper on the Queen's launch party that day. Soon flags throughout her country were at half-mast, as were the flags throughout Canada.